what I'm getting. Everything going very well as we prepare for a move to Pad A beginning at 8 this morning. At T-minus 19 minutes, 15 seconds and counting, this is shuttle transfer control. We've just had a report on the total weight of the mobile launch platform and the shuttle vehicle. It's 11,918,000 pounds. The crawler transporter will be transporting the vehicle to the pad at approximately 1 mile per hour. The complete journey to the pad will take approximately 5.5 hours, with an additional 1.5 hours needed before the mobile launch platform is hard down. Hard down is a term used by the engineers to describe the mobile launch platform being completely supported by the pedestals on the pad and no longer exerting any pressure on the crawler transporter. The speed of the crawler transporter was determined during the exercise with the Enterprise orbiter and the inert solid motors and external tank earlier this past year. The solid rocket booster hydraulic units are activated. The countdown now being conducted by the onboard computers with the ground computer acting as backup. T-minus 15, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4. We have a go for main engine start. We have main engine start. All three engines are up and running. Beautiful engine. Here we have a gimbling of those engines. We gimbal them sequentially with 1, 2, and 3. And we have had shutdown. We have had shutdown of all three engines. A full 20 second burn as expected. The crew is having breakfast at this time. They're having a traditional breakfast of orange juice, steak, eggs, toast, and coffee.
And a go has been given for them to move to the suiting room. John Young and Bob Crippen are walking out of the breakfast area now on their way to the suiting room. Astronaut John Young has put on his base helmet, locked it in place, and is in the present time they are testing to make sure that that system is working properly. Has sort of a tightening device which at the neck, which is pulled down to to ensure that we have absolute integrity. These are the suits which would protect them during the mission. T-minus 2 hours, 5 minutes, and holding. About 23 minutes remaining in this build-in hold as the astronauts John Young and Bob Crippen drive off toward the pad in the astronaut van. The crew is now moving across the swing arm, the orbiter access arm, toward the white room, the very clean area in which they will be prepared for entry into the orbiter. T-minus 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4. We've gone for main engine start. We have main engine start. And we have a liftoff of America's first space shuttle. And the shuttle has cleared the tower.
Roger. Columbia, Houston, you're go at throttle up.
Roger, go at throttle up.
Roger, Columbia on the nice ride. You're lofting a little bit, so you'll probably be slightly high at staging.
1 minute, 45 seconds coming up on go, no, go.
Columbia, you're negative seats.
That call up says that Columbia, the altitude is too high for ejection seat use.
Mark. Columbia, you're go for SRB SEP.
2 minutes, 4 seconds, standing by for SRB SEP confirmation.
Roger on the SEP, Columbia.
Mark, 2 minutes 20 seconds. Confirm solid rocket booster SEP.
down, you'll see Cape Kennedy, perhaps. There's a tremendous launch from there yesterday, which you may not have seen.
Oh, we saw it. Well, let's see. We're coming over. Oh, there we go. I got the runway and the VAD in sight.
Very good. It's exactly 24 hours ago. You've been there for one day now.
This is a shot down on our mid-deck storage area where we had all of our stuff stowed, and this was actually just after the press conference, or not press conference, after the conversation we had with the Vice President. Zero-G is something else. That is something that all of you should have an opportunity to experience. It is really fun.
If you could do that in your living room without breaking your leg, you sure would.
These are a couple of giant thunderstorms over the Amazon basins. These are the Himalayas. This is the empty quarter in Arabia.
Cape Cod and the Boston area. We're shutting the doors, and all of that again went just like we wanted it to. There were no problems at all associated with it. Got her all tucked away, and we're ready to come home.
Hello, Houston, Columbia's here.
Hello, Columbia, Houston's here. How do you read?
Glenn Quinn, and we're doing Mach 10.3 at 180 AS.
And we couldn't agree more, John. Your state vector's good. We've got good data in-house.
Okay, it looks to me like the L over D is normal.
Mark, Mach 9 at 9,700 feet per second.
Columbia, you got perfect energy, perfect ground track.
Roger that. What a way to come to California.
Right on glide slope. Approaching center line. Looking great.
This TV from the chase plane. Feet.
Mark 15.
Airspeed 271 knots. Fido says it couldn't be any better. Feet.
That's real good underneath.
Knots.
Everything looks real good. Clear. You're coming. You're down. 50 feet. 40. 30. 20. 10. 5. Three, two, one, touch down. Those gears, 10 feet. Five, four, three, touch down. Look above, skipper.
Wow. Welcome home, Columbia. Beautiful, beautiful.
You want us to take it up for hangar, Joe?
We're going to dust it off first.
It's the world's greatest all-electric fire machine, I'll tell you that. It was super.
Okay, convoy's on its way.
Convoy on. Wheel stop on the Columbia. Wheel stop.
This is Mission Control Houston. The unofficial touchdown time, 2 days, 6 hours, 20 minutes, 52 seconds. 2 days, 6 hours, 20 minutes, 52 seconds.
And Columbia Houston, we're estimating at least 26 more minutes on the ammonia. You're looking real good.
Going on the doors.
Roger.
Convoy is proceeding toward Columbia at this time. This is Mission Control Houston. We expect the crew to be able to get out of Columbia in about 45 minutes. That's a nominal time for safing and power down.
The main question that I've been asked since I got back was, what were you doing jumping around that spacecraft when you got out? Well, I'm proud to say what I was doing. And everyone had said that they had shown, from an engineering statistics standpoint, that it was impossible, mind you, that some of those critical tiles on the bottom of the vehicle would not fall off. None of those tiles fell off. And it's all due to the individual effort of the American people. They've proved that they can do the job. They proved it for the world to see. And I'm mighty proud to be associated with that kind of folks.